In this video, I'm gonna show you how to do another t-shirt design. I'm gonna design this one right here on Canva for free. You can follow along and see how I do it. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and my channel's all about helping you learn how to design and sell t-shirts online. If that's something you want to learn how to do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button right there. So in this video, I'm doing it again. I'm going to show you how to do a t-shirt design, and this time I'm going to be using Canva. I'm going to use the free version of Canva. Of course, there's the paid or pro version of Canva, but this one's going to be using all the free stuff. I'm going to show you step by step on how to do it, and you can learn how to do it on Canva. I'm going to show you different tips and tricks that I learned on Canva. I've been using it for a little bit now. I'm going to show you how to do some arc text. I'm going to show you how to do lots of different things. So in this video, you're going to want to stay to the end to see how I do the whole thing so that you can do something similar for yourself and hopefully get some sales when selling t-shirts like this online. So let's get on the internet and go to Canva, canva.com right now. All right, so here I am on Canva, canva.com, and you can see I'm using the free version, totally free. You'll see there's some things I can't use because I'm not on the pro version, but that's okay. We're gonna try and do everything for free to show you that you don't need to buy an app if you wanna just get started and do some t-shirts. You can start doing it right now. So first, create a design right here. I'm gonna go down and do custom size, and you can type in the width and the height. I've already done that, 4,500 by 5,400. That's the Merch by Amazon size, and that works great for other pod sites like Redbubble, TeePublic, and all of those. So I'm just gonna click that, and you can see here, I already have the artboard. So the next thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna find some elements to put on here. So I'm gonna go to Elements, and then I'm gonna type in Vintage Sunset. So let's just do that. Let's start with a Vintage Sunset. They actually have a bunch of them on Canva. A lot of them are pro. You can see here, pro, pro, pro. A lot of nice ones for pro, actually. So if you have the pro account, you got some really good vintage sunsets right here. But I'm gonna use the free one. So this one right here, I don't like this color. I'm gonna see what else they recommend. Magic recommendations. This is really cool. So if you pick something, Canva knows that there's some other things you might like. So I'm gonna check that out and see all. So that one was the free one, this colorful one. I kind of want a black background, so let me do that first and click on the artboard, click this, and then do black. So you can see that kind of looks good on black, but I want it more vintage style instead of more, this is kind of like unicorn color. So let's go back here and see what I got. Very limited, right? You can see a lot of crowns here. Let's see, scrolling down. This one's kind of cool, or this one. Let's just do this one. It's another one right here. All right, so let's make it big enough. I want it about that size right here. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do is find a silhouette to put on here. If you watch my recent videos about what to design in the winter time, there's lots of winter sports, right? So I'm gonna do skiing, because that's one, and just type in skiing here. And graphics, of course. And take a look at all these graphics. A bunch of them are free. Some of them are pro. I mean, most of them are pro, but I'm just gonna do this first one right here. And you can see it's already black. And I'm just gonna put it right there. Pretty cool, right? The next thing I'm gonna do is I wanna do some text. So let's do some rounded text. So I'm gonna go to text right here on the left-hand side, hit text, and the fastest way to do it is just hit add heading and then start typing. So I'm gonna say I'd rather, you can't see that, so let's put it up here. One of the cool things that Canva just added is adding color from a photo. So you may not have noticed, but this right here, this is a photo because when I hit edit image, you can see they give me some photo edit stuff. So a lot of times when you click photo, you don't have the colors on here. If you click colors, you only have the black one. I don't have the colors that are in the photo, but now you can have the color dropper in Canva. So click here, color picker right here. So click on this and then click on any of these colors right here and it's gonna match it. Check that out. Pretty cool, right? So if I did this again for this darker color, you see it matches it. So really easy to do. I'm gonna do one of these lighter ones right here. So I'm just gonna type in all caps, hit down your caps lock. I'd rather be. Oh, I forgot the R. I'd rather be. And then you can stretch it out like that. And then you may not know this, but you can have an effect on here. So click on here, effects. You can do shadow, lift, hollow, any of these cool ones. I might have to do a video of all of these showing you, but curve is the one we wanna do. Curve right here. And you can change the curve right here. So check this out. I want it to be bigger than the circle. So one way to do it is just to lift it above the circle like that. And then hit this until it's, you can see it's equal around the circle. So something like that. You're gonna have to eyeball it, maybe center it like that. So you see how that circle is around the sunset, vintage sunset circle? That's what we want right there. So that's how you do rounded text or arced text in Canva, real easy. I'm gonna pick a font that I really like. One thing you can do with fonts is to search different types of fonts. So if you wanna do like a rough font, you can type in rough, and look, they have all these things that have some kind of rough texture. See that? That's really cool. So if you want that vintage texture, you can do that. If you want something wide, just type in wide, and then now you have something wider, right? If you want something inline, you can type in inline. And then you got some of these with the lines in the middle. This, oh, that one's not free. You have to pick one that's free, not with the crown. So I jumped the gun there, but you can see this one has a line in the middle. This one has lines. One thing that I really like is this vintage font that I found. The one I found that I like is called Monotone, right here. Check this out. Look at that, it's so vintage looking, right? And let's let it go here. And you can see it may need some space in between these two words. So all I have to do is add another space. I'm gonna hit one there and one there. And there, cool. I'd rather be, and I'm gonna do skiing down here. But before I do that, I'm gonna put some trees in here just to add some extra texture. So let's do trees. I'm going back to elements and type in trees. And let's see what kind of, I love these trees right here. It's free. I'm gonna put them right here and I'm gonna make this black. So let's go here and make it black right there. And I'm gonna copy this, hold down option and drag, and you can see I'm just copying the same one. And then I'm gonna look for some other trees. So go back to graphics, type in trees again. And then this tree, oh, graphics, of course. And then this tree was free. So if I click these again, it's gonna do magic recommendations. So let's do that. And you can see this single tree, I like that one. So I'm gonna do that and get these out of the way. And then just kinda do this. I'm gonna hold down option again, put it down here. The trees, and just put trees all over the place. And I can make these smaller, right? So make this smaller like that. And he's kind of jumping the trees. Okay, and let's just make these all black. So I'm gonna select these and go here and do black. I should have done that before, but let's just do each one. Here, that's looking nice. Just kind of give each of them like a silhouette, right? And we can move things around here like this, you know. All right, and the next thing I'm gonna do is add rectangle. So let's just go here and do rectangle. And what I wanna do is kind of mask out the bottom here. So let's hit that rectangle, make this black, and kind of just have it across like this. Yeah. Cool, that's looking good. And the last thing I'm gonna do is do skiing at the bottom. So let's go back to text, add the heading, have my caps lock, do skiing, and then pick that font that we did, monotone right there. And then just scrunch this like this and then grab the corner and just make it bigger like that. Real easy, right? So let's just put this here. And look at that. I'd rather be skiing with some trees here. Now, if you wanna just move it around, cool, right? And we got this same color from here and this is how it's gonna look like on black. And we can download this and then we're gonna delete this black area so that it's a PNG on a black t-shirt. So let me show you how to do that. I'm just gonna hit download right here. And you can see, I can't do the transparent background on free, but I'm gonna show you how to do it for free on a Mac. If you have a PC, you may have to do some other things, but on a Mac, it's really easy. So let's do download. So I opened up my download, this PNG, right? You can see I opened it up in preview on my Mac, and all I have to do is click on this, and this right here, instant alpha, and click down and drag until you see it kind of turn red here. And everything's red except for if I hit delete, you can see some of these black ones right here. Now this isn't the best font to use to do this trick, but we're gonna do it. Let's zoom in here. You can scroll. So you wanna do these in between as well. Just do the same thing. Move to the right here and do the same thing for these. Like I said, this isn't the best font, but I love this vintage look, so we can still knock it out. Let's see if there's anything else we need to knock out. Oh, right here. It didn't quite capture these because they weren't connected. So let's do this as well. Delete, 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 delete. Now you don't have to be this picky, but I wanna be. Let's see if there's anything else. Yes, these right here. All right, yeah, that looks perfect. So now I can just take this PNG, it's the right size for Amazon and for Redbubble and TeePublic and whatever you want. I'm gonna show you what it looks like on Redbubble and we'll go from there. So here I am on Redbubble. I added new work. You can go here and add new work. And all you have to do is drag that PNG into here. So I'm gonna drag it right there. Boom. It's gonna take a little while. You wanna put your title, tags, and description. I'm not gonna show you how to do that in this video. I just wanna show you what it looks like on a t-shirt. So here it is on the regular t-shirt. You can see I knocked it out. So it looks good on these darker colors. There's black, blue. You can see this one, is that navy? I think that a dark blue, because you got charcoal. So you can now put it on these darker colors and it's perfect, right? Here's the large print right here. Look at that. Just so nice, right? And make sure when you do this on Redbubble to do the darker ones on these as well. If I were to put a background, I'd probably do just a black background. It's real easy to do, just like that. And you can see if I do that on Redbubble, they have the dark background on some of these other things. Now it doesn't make a nice sticker. You're gonna have to change the color for that or do an outline or whatever, but sticker doesn't work. But look at this on phone cases and on pillows, mouse pads, posters look great. Looks great on a giant shower curtain if someone wants to do that. Bags, clocks, books, just perfect, right? Doesn't look great on the tote bag, but there's so many products that it works well for here and here. So have fun with this. This is a real easy one to do. Now, of course, I don't know if this is trademarked or anything. You're gonna have to check USPTO to see if I'd Rather Be Skiing is trademarked. I just came up with that really quick. Don't copy the phrase. Don't even copy this design. Try it with a different silhouette, maybe different trees or something, different vintage sunset. I'm just showing you how to put it all together. And it's so simple to do the rounded text, find a good font. You saw how I did that with the different searches and just put it all together and then knock out all the black, right? So real easy to do. So have fun with this one. Hopefully this taught you some different skills you can do in Canva. I'm still learning Canva, so there's a lot of other things on there that I still need to learn. But this is something that you saw, it just took a few minutes to do, and you can start adding designs to Redbubble for free. It's free to sign up for Redbubble, free for Canva.com, the free version, and you can get started right away. and make some sales this month, next month, and in months to come. So have fun with this. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video was super helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you like these kinds of videos, if you'd like to see how easy it is to design videos, I can do lots of these in Canva, lots to learn on there. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. Before I finish this video, I wanted to leave with a question of the day, and the question of the day is this. What would you rather be doing instead of standing in line or whatever? Put that in the comments. I'd rather be skiing. I don't ski, but I could probably make for me, I'd rather be sleeping, or I'd rather be eating tacos or something like that. Let me know what you'd rather be doing in the comments. I think it would make a great t-shirt, whatever you come up with. So use that as your idea to make this. Thanks again for watching this video. And if you want to see more tutorials in Canva, click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.